This video is sponsored by the AfroBot. Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. If you're here from the previous video, glad to see you back. I assume that you've learned quite a few additional things from project number 6. If so, let's move on to project number 7, or temperature alarm. This project would utilize what we've learned from project number 6 by adding a temperature sensor to act as a trigger to sound an alarm using the buzzer when a certain threshold range or value is reached. Let's go! For this project, we would only need to add a few components into the mix. Some additional male-to-male jumper cables, and an LM35 temperature sensor. Now let's get our temperature sensor and connect it to the prototyping shield like this. Remember that the flat side of the sensor should be facing us. Let's connect the left leg of the sensor to 5 volts using a red jumper cable. Connect the middle leg to DF Arduino's analog pin number 0 using a blue jumper cable, and the right leg to the ground pin using a black jumper cable. That's it! I guess I just moved the sensor back quite a bit to make it easier to see. And there we have it! Let's plug in the DF Arduino board to the computer. Moving on to the code demo, as always, I'm going to use the DF robot provided sample codes. Make sure that the MCU is being detected and we're using the correct board. Click on verify, then upload the code. Okay, so according to this, if the temperature's value is greater than 27 degrees Celsius, the buzzer will be turned on. And just like what it said, it did turn on the buzzer, and since we did not have any duration to the code, it would continuously sound the alarm until the temperature value becomes less than 27 degrees Celsius. The serial monitor is telling us that the temperature is around 30 degrees Celsius, and in order to turn it off, you have to lower the temperature that the LM35 sensor is detecting. So using my grabber tool, I'm going to put it up right in front of my AC.
Let me just change the fan settings on my AC full speed real quick because it's on auto.
As you may have noticed, the alarm is starting to stutter now. That means that it's detecting temperature that is less than 27 degrees Celsius, but not entirely. Remember, temperature sensors like this can be quite erratic if not given enough time to sense environmental temperature, which is really visible on the serial monitor. And there we go. Now that the buzzer finally stopped, let's watch it go back to life again.
Just gonna change my AC settings back to auto again because it's getting a bit cold.
By the way, just for transparency, the indoor temperature since earlier is 25 degrees Celsius, but it still kept on sounding the alarm, which I did not really understand why. I'm not really sure if the results are based on what temperature it can actually sense or on what temperature the IC is. And just as I have returned my camera to the tripod, it started sounding off the alarm again. As you can see on the serial monitor, it's saying that the temperature is almost 30 degrees, which is clearly not the case. You can check my review of this wireless hygrometer and temperature monitor right here if you want. Well, it's getting a bit annoying now, so that's it for the code demo. Here's how the code works. Right off the bat, on the variable declaration, we can see three familiar data types. Float synval and int toneval from the previous project, and unsigned long, which we have already talked about on project number 3. I suggest to rewatch it if you forgot how they work. On void setup, we also have some familiar code. Digital pin number 8 where the buzzer is connected is set up as an output, and serial begin 9600 to set up the serial monitor and baud rate. Okay, let's head straight to the void loop. Here, we have a variable called val to store the values from the LM35 sensor and save it as an integer. Values from the variable val would come from the LM35 pin. Double data. Double or double precision floating point number occupies 4 bytes. That is, the double implementation is exactly the same as float with no gain in precision. And data, which is the variable for the data type double. Val equals analog read 0. As the name suggests, it reads the values from DF Arduino's analog pin 0 and saves them to the variable called val. Analog read only has one parameter, which is where the analog pin is located. The analog read command converts the input voltage of 0 to 5 volts to digital values between 0 and 1023. This is handled by the analog to digital converter circuit inside the MCU. Each sensor value corresponds to a value of voltage. The voltage value of temperature read here outputs a range between 0 to 1023. Every 10 millivolts is equal to 1 degree Celsius on the LM35 sensor. Now, let's convert the voltage value to temperature. On this line of code, we would use the voltage values from analog read, which has a value range of 0 to 1023 for the val variable. So, 5 divided by 10.24 is equal to 0.48828125 millivolts. After getting the quotient, we need to get the value from analog read. Let's just say that it's giving a reading or value of 615, for example. Multiply the val, or 615, to the quotient, and the product is 300.2929688 millivolts. Now, since every 10 millivolts is equal to 1 degree Celsius, let's divide 300.2929688 millivolts by 10. 300.2929688 divided by 10 is equal to 30.02929688, or 30 degrees Celsius. Now that we have our data, let's move on to the if-else statement. If data or temperature data, which is currently 30, is greater than 27, it would activate the block of code below. In fact, the block of code inside the if statement is actually the majority of project number 6's code.
Just wanted to mention it because we will not discuss it here anymore.
Inside else, we have an advanced I/O called NoTone. NoTone only has a single parameter, which is pin, or where the buzzer is connected, and its main purpose is to stop the generation of a square wave triggered by tone. Right below it, we have a time function called millis and an unsigned data type inside the if statement. Millis returns the number of milliseconds passed since the MCU or board began running the current program. We've already used unsigned long on project number 3, so I won't explain it here again. This block of code right here basically just tells the serial monitor to print temperature values in Celsius every 500 milliseconds. That's it! I know that it can be quite confusing, so for a more in-depth explanation, please refer to the PDF. Click right here if you feel ready to move on to the next project. See ya!